Me a video about how to solve an improper integral, and we have basically an improper integral right here for this integral from 0 to 1 of x ln x. And the way that you know that this is an improper integral is because you can't actually plug in 0 to ln x, because the ln of 0 doesn't actually work, doesn't make any sense. To explain why you can't have ln of 0, let me show you really quick. So let's just say ln of 0 is equal to some value x. I'm just making that up for now. If we were trying to solve for what ln of 0 is, you can see that it's impossible if by just doing a little bit of simplification. So I'm basically base-ing both sides, and you end up with 0 is equal to e to the x. So if you think about it for a second, some base e to some power x could never equal 0. This will never equal 0. If you approach negative infinity, it would approach 0, but it's never actually equal to 0. So that's why ln of 0 is undefined. It's actually impossible to figure that out. So because of that, we're going to need to rewrite this integral so that it actually makes sense with limits rather than an improper integral the way it's written right now. But the first thing I'm going to do is actually find what this integral is. I'm going to simplify it as much as I can first before actually rewriting everything and working out that integral. So first thing you should notice is x ln x, you're going to need integration by parts for this. And if you remember the Lie-8 rule for integration by parts, it's best to start with a log for your value of u. So I'm going to say that my value of u is ln x, and that means my du is equal to 1 over x dx. My dv is going to be whatever's left, which is just in this case x dx. And then my v is going to be 1 half x squared. All right, so from here, I'm going to rewrite the integral, and it would be equal to uv, which is in this case 1 half x squared times ln x minus the integral of 1 half x squared times 1 over x dx. Okay, some simplifying occurs here with this x squared and this x right here. So you end up with 1 half x, which is going to simplify to 1 half x squared over 2 plus c. So if you were going to rewrite all that again, it would just be 1 half x squared ln x minus 1 fourth x squared plus c. We don't really need a plus c for this, but I'm just writing it down to be more exact. All right, so now that we have that antiderivative, I'm going to rewrite the integral up here using limits. So I'm going to say the limit as a approaches 0. Now, it's important to note that you can approach 0 in this problem. You can only approach it from the right because it's going to 1. So you need to be between 0 and 1, but not include the 0. So to be between the 0 and 1, you have to go from 0 from the right side. And we're integrating this. This value right here, the antiderivative that we found a second ago. And we're plugging in a, because a is approaching 0, and then we're plugging in 1. So now to solve this, we're going to use the first fundamental theorem of calculus. So I'm going to plug in 1 for the x's here, and you're going to end up with, well, ln of 1 is 0, so this whole thing's gone. So it's just going to be 0 minus 1 fourth. So you're going to end up with negative 1 fourth when you plug in the 1. Then you plug in the a, we're going to subtract that. So you're going to end up with 1 half squared, 1 half a squared ln of a minus 1 fourth a squared. Now for here we have this ln of a, and if you do direct substitution, you end up with something that's approaching negative infinity, but we're kind of lucky because this a squared right here, a is approaching 0 for that. All right, so an interesting thing happens here. So we can pull this negative 1 fourth out right here. But an interesting thing happens here when we try to use the limit to solve this thing right here. We end up with 1 half times 0, some value that's approaching 0, times ln of a, and a is approaching 0, so it's ln of 0. So you end up having a 0 value times an infinity value, which ends up becoming an indeterminate form. So that means we're going to have to use L'Hopital's rule to solve this. So what I'm going to do is kind of pull this thing out right here and try to solve it really quick. So you end up with, I'm gonna rewrite this whole thing right here to be ln of a divided by a to the negative 2. Now the reason I did this was, since it's a fraction, now I can use L'Hopital's rule, which means the derivative of the top. So if I can do the derivative of the top, it's 1 over a. The derivative of the bottom is going to be negative 2a to the negative 3. From here, I can simplify this because this is technically just going to be a over. So basically, I can rewrite this to be a to the negative 1. If you recall the exponent property, what you can do is you can subtract, since they have the same bases, they both have an a base, you can subtract these powers here. So you're going to end up with negative 1/2 a squared. Now, since a is going to 0, this ends up just being 0. This whole thing just ends up being 0. So what we can do is rewrite this limit up here to be equal to 0. So this part 0 times 1/2 is just still going to be 0. So it's going to be minus 0 minus. Now, a is going to 0 for this one, so that ends up being 0 as well. So your final answer ends up just being this negative 1/4. Okay, this is a pretty involved improper integral problem. There's a lot of moving parts. There's a lot of steps to this. As you can see, it's a ton of work, but I feel like it's a pretty good example for improper integration. Let's take a look at the graph really quick and see if this makes sense that it's negative 1/4. All right, so this time we're going to integrate from 0 to 1 of f of x dx. And it actually does spit out the value, which it really shouldn't technically, because 0 you can't actually plug in. But I'm assuming this calculator kind of understands that already and just takes it into account. And because if you try to do f of 0, it doesn't end up working out because it's undefined. But it still ended up working out on this, which is kind of nice. One thing you could have done if it didn't work is you could just put in like 0.01. And if you just get closer and closer to that 0, it ends up being negative 0.25. That's basically an example of an improper integration problem. If you have any questions about anything in this video, let me know.